you have 10 odd minutes to spare and want to see some artwork? I'll personally bring you to an art tour of my work. Hi, welcome to my show. And this is the front door as you walk into the show, the exhibition. And right off the bat, there's this Angel Gabriel. It's an easy piece. I did it, did the preliminary lines, and then I realized the images are already there. So there's not too much of a hardship in between. And for this card here says AR possibility. So for this one, you could actually point your phone, download the app, and have a look at the animation behind it. And as you can see, this is where the wing is, and then the head, the neck. I would have done more if there were more lines here. I feel it's still a bit empty, but nevertheless, it is what it is. And as you walk over here, you see memories, which were one of the first two pieces that I did. That's the first one. And Passing Beauty, this one is actually the second one I did in this series of blue. And then I went down, the camera went down here. This is the Regime of Tyranny, which I explained again and again. That really relates to what happens in Hong Kong. And this memory piece has also got the AR possibility inside, hidden. And this one, at one point I was going to give up on it because it's so difficult. I see the figure, the head, the shoulder, elbow, the wing, it's all there. But somehow it really took me a long time to work on it. Unlike the Angel Gabriel here, which was quite easy. So sometimes it's easier and sometimes it's hard. It really depends on the preliminary lines that came by. And Passing Beauty, the AR behind it, there's a girl moving from left to right, walking, and you would see that the background animation on this one, the video, incorporate a few different combinations of technique and video. So I'm actually still learning from it. I'm not a master yet, but it's fun to do. The cloak, it's also one of the harder pieces because I wanted the space to be there, and yet I don't want the whole cloak to be black. And this figure is rather awkward to be protruding over there. And yet you can still see the angel and death or whatever it is. I don't plan on doing something like that right off the bat. I just found the images. So if you ask me why I do that, probably it's because life and death is somehow something that I like to work on. It's one of the many themes that I work on. For this one, the magician, I see this as the magician. And in the background AR, you see at the very end of the AR, you see the figure flowing out. Because this has been a white area to until the very end, I decided to totally cover it with blue, eliminating it to give it a bit more space so that this magician could walk around. If you look at the AR, you'll see what I mean on this one. For each work, I try to use different techniques. If you look closer here, you see the blue being painted on. Actually, I started to use enamel on top, an enamel glaze on top of the blue, just so to try to change the blue color into a more, to give it a bit more different blue to the work. I try to experiment on each and every piece of work instead of staying on the same thing all over. It's kind of boring for me, so if it's boring for me, I think the viewer will find it boring as well. So each of these work are very, very different in themselves. Okay, this one is called the Girl in the Bandana. So you can see the bandana here, the face, the shoulder. I try to work on this one as if it is a collage. So you see it looks as if it's finished, but if you see it in terms of collage, it's got patches of different colors, different texture, and to balance the page. I like the air that passed through all of these spaces. If the whole work is done, like it's all colored, the whole work would be very, very boring and solid, very overly finished. Like this one. This was completed at the end of 2018, and it's a diptych, two pieces. You see the line here. I was working in this size then, and then I realized I wanted to do something more to the sheet, and also expanding on the sides as well. So I started to combine two together. And this work is the only work in this show with an addition of lines, and that is the hand. The hand poses a bridge so that the viewer could really see what's going on in the picture. If you look at it and you just see two white areas, you don't really see it that clearly that these are two figures. But with a hand, it gives the clue to the body, the golden cloak on the body, and then you see the head, and then you see it's looking down, and then you realize, oh, there's a man there as well. So then they are talking in the midnight hours. For this one, I also added patterning onto the figure as well. You see, if you stand closer, you see these patterning. So this one is a very exciting piece in terms of lines, shape and form. It's got a lot on it. However, I do feel it's a bit over finished, unlike the Girl in the Bandana. So this is an introduction to the show. And if you are interested in more, email me or go to my homepage, or even download the app and watch some of these AR behind the work. Well, thank you very much for coming to my show, and I'll see you whenever.